Now let's take a look at the App Store. The App Store is more than just a place where you purchase your apps. It's also where you can go and find which apps have been updated and what the updates are. You can manage your subscriptions. You can even see what apps you've purchased in the past and download those. Let's take a look at the App Store on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Let's go ahead and open up the App Store. It is just an app on your iPhone. So I tap on it to open it up. Now, you're probably familiar with the basics here. We have our categories down at the bottom. And when we're looking at an app, we're able to see if we've downloaded it before or if we haven't. So if it has a cloud, that means that you've downloaded it before, so you can download it again. If it doesn't have the cloud and it has Get, that means that you can download it for free, but it does have an in-app purchase. You're going to see it says in-app purchase there. So that's the basics of downloading the apps. But what about finding your apps that you've downloaded before? Or seeing which apps have been updated and what has been updated? Or even viewing your subscriptions? Well, in order to do that, what you need to do is you need to go to the very top. So I'm just going to swipe down until I get to the top here. And then you're going to see this little icon here. This is your account icon. This is where we can see our subscriptions, what apps we purchased, as well as any updates. So let's first take a look at updates. How do I find out what has been updated? Well, I'm in my account here. You're going to see it says account here. And now all I need to do is just swipe up and you're going to see that I can see what my updates are. So these are my upcoming automatic updates. And when I do swipe up, I can see what has been updated recently. Now, what are the updates for a specific app? Well, if we go to any one of the apps that have been updated, you're going to see it says More. When I tap on More, I'm actually able to see the update. Now, some developers are a little more detailed in this than others. Let's go and take a look at Perplexity. Maybe this has a little more detail. And we can see it has various bug fixes. Sometimes this is where they will go and announce a new feature. So I'm going to swipe up here. And Travel Planner is an app that I have. And that developer is pretty good about informing us. When I tap on More here, what I'm able to do is see what issues he fixed. So he fixed an issue where the weather would display on the wrong day, and he fixed an issue where the landscape view of the address would display in other screens. So it's completely up to the developer to share what has been updated. Let's go back up to the top and see what other information we have in this account area here. The next one here we're going to look at is apps. Now, with apps, what we're able to do is see what has been downloaded. This is a family account, so I can see what other people have downloaded down here. And if I want to see what I've downloaded, I tap on My Apps, and then I can see what I've downloaded. Now, the nice thing about this view is I can see all of the apps, or if I just want to see the ones that I don't have installed on this iPhone, I can tap on that, and then it'll show me all of the apps that I've downloaded that are not on this iPhone. And then if I want to download any of them, I just tap on the little cloud. So that's how you can see which app you've downloaded and which ones have not been installed on your iPhone or are not installed on your iPhone. I'm going to go back. And then we also have subscriptions here. When I tap on this, I can see all of my different subscriptions. And then from there, I'm able to renew them or cancel them. I tap on one. Let's go ahead and tap on Bulletin here. What I'm able to do is tap on it. And then I can see that I've canceled this. And if I want to renew it, I'm able to renew it. If it was an active subscription, I'd be able to cancel it here. So that's how you can monitor your subscriptions. Go back here. I also can see my purchase history. So this is a little bit different from the apps that you've downloaded. This is your purchase history. So from here, what I'm able to do is see what I've purchased, not what I've downloaded. So we can see that I purchased Fly. That's for the Apple Vision Pro. Great app, by the way. And then I also have my Apple Care here, which I've purchased. So it's not necessarily what you've downloaded, but it's what you've purchased. Let's go back. And then we have notifications. This is where you can turn on and off your notifications for the App Store. And then if you want to redeem a gift card or send a gift card to someone, you can do that from here as well. So that's a look at the App Store. Like I said, in addition to where you go and download apps for your iPhone, it's a place where we can go and monitor our subscriptions. We can see what apps we've purchased as well as which ones have not been downloaded on your iPhone. And then you can also view your purchase history. So that's how the App Store works, in addition to being a place where you can go and download your apps.